Israel. I love the Jewish people, but they don't love Jesus. They crucified him. They said that, and the funny thing is, when they said this, they said that, let his blood be in our hands and our children's hands. Yeah. Well, you know something? That's what's happening today.
Yeah.
We got the leadership, and I'm going to tell you, if you think these elections are up and up, then you've got another thing coming.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is coming from the pits of hell to bring in this one world system.
Yep.
You've got to shut up. Don't you question it.
Right.
Yes.
And when it comes, are you going to be too late to stand before the king? Ron DeSantis said here a month ago, at the end of his speech, he says, above all, take on the whole armor of God. And this afternoon, I'll bring that banner. And we made a banner up for him. We set it down, 10 of them, and a big 8x16, and they gave them to him one. But we want to go. There's 67 counties in the state of Florida. My wife and I, we're going to go and we'll sponsor 10 banners in every county. There's billions and billions and billions of empty walls and fences throughout America. Every one of them has a potential to magnify the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
9:17 in Romans, he says, I will declare the name of my God throughout the earth.
Hallelujah.
Well, why are we doing that? Look, he's proclaiming Jesus. He has a testimony. Listen to his testimony.
Amen.
And why wouldn't you do it? If someone tells me they don't want to wear a t-shirt, they want to don't put a magnet on their car, I say, why not? God will never tell you not to magnify his name.
That's right.
He says in 34:3-4, come magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name.
Yeah.
The 60th Psalm, the 4th verse says, I've given a banner to them that fear me, that the banner might be displayed because of the truth. 14:16 in John, he says, I am the way, the truth, and life. Why wouldn't we want to do that? 12:32, he says, if I'm lifted up. There's that word. When you read the Bible, look at that word if.
Yeah.
If you follow me,
amen,
you'll have eternal life.
Amen.
But if you turn away, I'll forsake you.
Yep.
That's why it says in 28:9 in 1 Chronicles, I, the Lord, I search the heart. I know the imaginations of all your thoughts.
Yeah.
And if you seek me, you'll find me. But if you turn away from me and forsake me, I will cast you off forever.
Yeah.
29:11, Jeremiah, I know the thoughts that he has for every one of us in here. Thoughts of good and not of evil, to give you an expected end. Some of you might have an unexpected end because you're running. You're not in the will of God. You're in your own will. Then you'll come up, call upon me, and you'll pray unto me, and I'll hearken to your voice. You'll seek me and find me. When you seek me with all your heart, I'll be found of you. This is real. Are you in that word daily? Are you contending for the cross of Jesus Christ, or are you like the rest of the world in the church, a pretender?
Right.
God's not looking for pretenders.
That's right.
So when you go out tonight, there's people dying. They're hurting. Some of them are homosexual. Some of them are homeless.
Yeah.
The kindness of God. He said he's kind and to the unthankful and the evil in 6:35 in Luke. God is good to all. His tender mercies are over all of his creation. What kind of people should we be? There's no more I can be mean to anybody or yell at anybody. Or I don't care if they're a homosexual, a heathen. And 46:10 in the Psalms says, be still and know that I'm God. I'm going to be exalted amongst the heathen. I'm going to be exalted in planet Earth. I'm kind to everybody.
Amen.
That's just my nature. You can do whatever you want. But my nature is to get into my word, get on my knees. Hey, have a great day today.
Amen.
Me too. Who knows? Someone might need one of your smiles. A smile might change their life.
Amen.
Right.
Can you do that? Can you say, Lord, humble me? I don't want to be haughty. I don't want to be so great that I think that I'm going to be judging another when I do the same things it says in Romans 2.
Right.
He that says you shouldn't commit adultery, am I watching pornography? Jesus broke it down pretty good in the 5th chapter of Matthew. Whosoever committeth a lust upon a woman in his heart has committed adultery already.
That's right. Yeah.
He that's angry with his brother, you're a murderer. That's what it says. Mm-hmm. Are you so great that you can't humble yourself to be kind to everybody? Then go say, can I pray for you? I've got a word for you. Make sure it's a word from God. The Bible says in 22:21 in the book of Proverbs, God will make everybody in here know the certainty of the words of truth, that we might answer the words of truth to them that God sends our way.
Amen.
How can you know the words of truth if you're never into the living bread?
That's right.
How can you say I'm a man of God, but you don't want anything to do with the real living God?
Right.
You want to do what you want to do.
Yep.
The will of God is to do the will of him that God sent, Jesus Christ. How much longer do I have? 5 minutes. I'm gonna end this up that you have a choice. Joshua simply said in 24:15, but me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord.
Amen.
Right now we've got 25 banners in Las Vegas that say Jesus is the answer.
Amen.
Hope in Jesus. He heals the broken in hearts.
Right. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
12 million eyes a month see that in Las Vegas of a population of 2.5 million people. Maybe time and time again. We had one coming from our ranch in Montana. All it said was five, I don't know if you saw it then, but we had, I missed you, God. That's kind of benign, right? I missed you, God. Oh, big deal. Well, I got a call the next day. And the gal said, this gal came into the beauty shop where I was at, and she was crying. I said, what happened? She had turned from living from Jesus. She had turned from living for Jesus. Saw that sign, I missed you, God, and she started weeping. She said, that sign, that day, was for me. And she gave her life back to Jesus.
Praise God.
If you tell me that you can't go ahead and put a magnet on your car, then I need to talk to you privately. Because one vehicle, I'm serious about this, one vehicle, thousands of eyes a month will see Jesus, the King of Kings, who has come to set the captives free.
That's right.
And if you're ashamed to do that, you might hear on that day, depart from me. I don't know who you are.
Yep.
You couldn't even put my name on your vehicle. Just a little magnet that said, the King of Kings. So if you're ashamed of me, I'll be ashamed of you. You're denying me. Listen to how David give his testimony. We had one over at the Topless Bar over by the Rio. And at the time we were doing what happens in Vegas, God knows the wages of sin or death. We had to take those down because they said, you can't do that. It's copyrighted and trademarked. So, but we got a call. I'd taken them all down. I said, I'm not going to do it anymore. I was whining. Are you a whiner? Are you whining? I was whining. I don't want to do it anymore. Does anybody care? Does anybody see it? I get back to Montana 2 weeks after I take it down, go to this little church where we had the SOPA. And the guy said, I got to talk to you after the church. I said, what's it about? He said, well, I got to tell you a story. So he said, I was in Judith Gap 2 weeks ago. I told him, don't put him up anymore. And a guy came over and started talking. He says, yeah, I was in Vegas 2 weeks ago, and I was going to this topless bar over by the Rio, and I pulled in, I saw this sign, and then I was going to go get a hooker, and I was going to get a prostitute, and I was just going to, I was going to oogle the women. And it was from Montana. Why would God do that? Why would God, when I humbled myself, tell me to go to a garbage can and then go to another garbage can? You can tell me whatever you want. I call it a miracle.
Yeah,
I am amazed. I mean, I just... Right now, I just said, Lord, I just want to praise you.
Yes, Lord.
Because you're worthy.
Yes, Lord.
So the guy says, he says, oh, I pulled up and I saw this big lit up sign at the topless bar. And he said, I started shaking. And I backed up and left.
Wow.
I called Lamar the next day and I said, put him up under the earth. We went, had one. Anybody know where Little Darlings is?
Yeah.
Oh, you do? I usually ask the pastors that, and they say they do. But anyway, we had one of Little Darlings. So here, 8, 9, 10 years ago, we had a big one up, the Ten Commandments, the wages of sin or death. And the guy was valeting over there. And so we pulled up and said, hey, what do you think of the sign? He said, man, it's effing weird, man. We had a graffiti. I didn't say anybody's F word. We go over, about 2 minutes later, he came over and said, I want to apologize. But I've been looking at that sign for over 2 hours. You pull out off the hop, topless nude grand opening, you pull out, you see a sign right now, a billboard in Las Vegas. Jesus is the answer.
Amen.
You pull out of the Little Darlings right now, you go around the corner, repent and believe the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
It's his word that's quick and powerful.
Amen.
Sharper than a two-edged sword. God is heavy. I'm going to tell you one last story. Up in Montana, our gate fell down. We took it down, put a new gate up. And I said, our ranch is called Little Honey Ranch. I said, well, we're going to put Little Honey Ranch. And my wife says, we are not putting up Little Honey Ranch. We're putting up Jesus Christ as Lord.
Woo!
When people come by, they're looking at it, they're confessing it, they're professing it, and we put it up. If anybody wants to see a picture of it, I'll show you. I'm going to tell you what. Right now, Jesus said in 2:9-11 of Philippians, says, God is highly, not just exalted, he's highly exalted the
Amen.
Name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Giving him a name above every name.
Yes,
just
Lord.
At the name of Jesus. Every knee will bow in heaven. Think about it. They're bowing in heaven to this Lord.
Yeah.
89:7 in the Psalm that says, God is to be greatly feared in the assembly of his saints and had in reverence of all that are about him. Shouldn't today we have a little reverence about him?
Come on.
So we went ahead and then it simply said that It will declare that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of the Father.
Amen.
The Father. So
Amen.
All I'm saying is, while you're here, get in a prayerful mood. The Bible says the will of God is to pray without ceasing.
Yes.
And in all things, give thanks, for this is the will of God in your life. But anyway, this is the conclusion of the whole matter, that you and I fear God, we keep his commandments.
Yes.
This is the whole duty of man, for God will bring every work into judgment. Think about that.
Yes.
Don't be so proud that you think you're not going to be judged. God will bring every work into judgment with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. Anyway, rejoice in the Lord while you're here.
Amen.
Encourage each other, lift each other up, but above all, give him all the glory.
Amen. Amen. Amen.